Hello everyone, and welcome to Sign of Our Time. My name is Bruce, and it's time to upgrade our skills so that we can factor higher degree polynomials, such as cubic polynomials with a degree of 3, quartic polynomials with a degree of 4, and polynomials with even higher degrees. In the last video in this series, we were asked to factor a cubic polynomial with a leading coefficient of 1 by using the integral zero theorem. But what if we were asked to factor a cubic polynomial with a leading coefficient that is not equal to 1? Well, I'm about to show you. Let's consider a question like this, where we are asked to fully factor 2x cubed plus 9x squared plus 7x minus 6. Unfortunately, we cannot rely on the integral zero theorem because the leading coefficient is not equal to 1. In order to be able to fully factor this problem, I have to introduce you to yet another theorem, and this is the rational zero theorem. The rational zero theorem states that if ax minus b is a factor of a polynomial function p of x with integer coefficients, then each rational zero x equals b over a is such that, number one, b is a factor of the constant term of p of x, and number two, a is a factor of the leading coefficient of p of x. Breaking this down, let's first ensure that the leading coefficient is not equal to 1, which clearly it isn't, since the leading coefficient is equal to 2. Next, let's check to see that all of the coefficients are integers, which is the case. With these checks complete, we can now work towards finding the first factor of this polynomial, ax minus b, by first listing all of the possible values of b, which are factors of the constant term of negative 6. And don't forget to include both positive and negative values. Secondly, we can work to write down all of the possible values of a, which are factors of the leading coefficient of 2. According to the rational zero theorem, each rational zero will have the form b over a. So let's work to create a list of all of the possible values of b over a, starting with a is equal to 1. We get 1 over 1, 2 over 1, 3 over 1, and 6 over 1. And we should not forget to include both positive and negative values. Now let's move on to a is equal to 2, where the possible values of b over a are 1 over 2, 2 over 2, 3 over 2, and finally 6 over 2. At this stage, let's just simplify these fractions where possible. And notice that we do get some repeated values, such as plus or minus 1 and plus or minus 3. Now, we don't want to test these values twice, so we make sure that we only include them once in our final set of values of b over a to test. Now we can start by testing these possible values of b over a using the factor theorem to see which ones make the polynomial function equal 0. My advice is always to start testing from the lowest number and then working our way up to the highest number. Let's start by testing negative 1 over 2, which gives us a value of negative 15 over 2, which tells us that negative 1 over 2 is not a rational zero of this polynomial. Let's move on to positive 1 over 2, which does make the polynomial function equal to 0, yes! Which tells us that positive 1 over 2 is a rational zero. In other words, a is equal to 2 and b is equal to 1, meaning that 2x minus 1 is a factor of this polynomial. But what about the other factor or factors? Well, there are two strategies in order to find out what these are. The first strategy, and the one that I very highly recommend, is to use synthetic division or even long division, where we can take the polynomial and divide by the first factor that we have just discovered. But please be very careful when using synthetic division with divisors of the form ax plus or minus b. Here, we need to take the 2 and the 10 and the 12 and divide those values by 2 in order to get the coefficients of the quotient. Now, if you're not sure why this is done, then I recommend that you check out the video in the link above. Now we just need to focus on x squared plus 5x plus 6, which is a quadratic that can easily be factored to give us x plus 2 multiplied by x plus 3. At this stage, we have fully factored this polynomial. The second strategy is just to continue testing possible values of b over a by using the factor theorem. From this, we can see that b has a value of negative 2 in one of the remaining factors. And we can also see that b has a value of negative 3 in the other remaining factor. When simplified, we get the fully factored form of this polynomial, which is 2x minus 1, x plus 2, and x plus 3. Now, I don't recommend that you use the second strategy for several reasons. Number one, it can be quite time consuming, especially when we have several values of b over a to test. Number two, it can get quite tricky working with fractions and raising them to various powers, meaning that there's more room for us to make a mistake. Number three, this strategy only works if the remaining factor or factors are binomials. But it is entirely possible that the remaining factor or factors could be quadratic in nature and may not factor any further. In which case, further testing values of b over a would be futile because none of those values would make the polynomial equal to zero. We would have to use synthetic division or long division in order to get the remaining factor or factors. Okay, take some time to absorb all of the information in this video, and when you're ready, try out this question and let me know what your answer is in the comments below. If you feel that you've learned something valuable from this lesson, then please let me know. And if you'd like to consider the idea of further supporting me and my work on Patreon, then please click on the link in the description below to learn more. Well, that's all from me, and I'd like to say a very big thank you for watching.